we are discussing about the wireless transmission. In communication, wireless transmission is done by electromagnetic waves, and the signals, after due modulation, the waves, carrier waves, are sent from transmitter to receiver through a channel. And now we are discussing that channel. Between transmitter, receiver, there is a channel, and this channel for electromagnetic wave is the space. Now, in the space again, we can send these waves by three methods. How are these three methods? If this is surface of the earth, ground of the earth, we can have one tower here, antenna. Number one, for transmitting an electromagnetic wave, the thing we need is antenna. An antenna will radiate electromagnetic wave, and on the receiving side there will be another antenna which will receive this. So there should be resonance between the two. The signal from here will be received by this. Okay, so the last device from which EM waves will be radiated will be an antenna. The first device in the receiver, which is receiving the waves, is an antenna. So this antenna has a size, and we use it lambda by 4 size of antenna. That means if the wavelength of the wave is 1000 millimeter, then the antenna should be 250 millimeter. So it depends upon the wavelength we are sending. Okay, that is for the antenna. Now, when wave is sent from one antenna to the other, from transmitter to the receiver, there are three methods of sending it. Okay, here is transmitter, here is, suppose, receiver. One method is, we send our waves if the receiver is here, and from here the waves will go like this. That is parallel to the surface of the earth and received here. These are close to the ground. The distance is now large. They cannot go. We can have another method. That is, we know one property of the atmosphere, that it is capable of reflecting electromagnetic waves. It is a total internal reflection, but they are able to reflect it. So we target with help of an antenna our waves to the, yes, here, atmosphere. And from the atmosphere, they are reflected by the rules of reflection and are sent back to Earth. They are received here, okay, for so much distance. Even if the distance is larger, smaller or larger, there is another method. More powerful waves we can send to crossing all the atmosphere of the earth, going through the space, and they will come here to a satellite. This satellite will receive it and transmit it back towards the earth. This way, and an antenna here can catch it. So we have categorized our propagation of the waves in three categories. This, which is going parallel to the ground, is known as, this method is known as ground wave propagation. This method, which is coming from the sky, is known as sky wave propagation. And this, which is going to the space and coming back by satellite, is known as space propagation. And if we are taking help of satellite, then we will call it satellite propagation. There are two type of this. In one, we are taking help of satellite. In other, we are not taking help of satellite. It is line of sight propagation. So, we have to study these three, one after the other. First, we will start with ground wave propagation. The ground wave propagation is used for low frequency. How does it go and why do we use low frequency? This is the surface of the earth. On the surface of the earth, we have one antenna here and it is transmitting the electromagnetic waves. And here we have another antenna, this. And this antenna will receive the waves. So antenna to antenna, and these waves are parallel to ground. They are going parallel to ground, received by this and it is transmitted. Okay, during this what happens? During this there are oscillation plus to minus, minus to plus. So they induce another wave in the earth, surface of the earth. Surface of the earth. Okay, so this is plus, this is minus, this is plus, this is minus, plus, minus. There is an induction with the earth. This is earth surface. Here comes a positive field, there is an induction here. A negative field is induced in the earth. Here comes a negative field. There is an induction, here is positive field. So, once we have this plus, minus, on the earth we have minus, plus, minus, plus, minus. So, what happens with this? Answer is, when this thing happens, then there are always chances that this plus and this minus, there will be a short circuit to some extent, plus minus, there will be short circuit to some extent. So what happens with this? There is always certain leakage of energy because of this short circuiting. Every field, whether it is positive or negative, would like to go to zero potential, that is earth. It would, a positive charge would like to go to negative charge, a positive field by negative field is eliminated, neutralized. So this plus with this minus is neutralized. So if we have a large strength here, say here the field was 100, here it become 70, here it become 50, here it become 30, and then it becomes 0. And this happens very fast, because the moment one wave goes, there is an induced wave on the surface, and that leads to attenuation. Induced wave in the ground attenuate this electromagnetic wave at a short range. Therefore, this is a short range communication. Further, another feature is the frequency we used has to be kept small. Why? The answer is, if it is a small frequency, the wavelength is very large, then the chances of, there are certain chances of short circuiting. From this to this, how many chances are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. This way, there are 5 chances of short circuiting for this particular frequency. And now, if I am using a higher frequency, then it will be like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Here, there are 4 chances of, or 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 chances of short circuiting. Here, there are 10 chances of short circuiting. So, there will be 10 times short circuiting here, and here If the power was P, it reduced to P by 2. Here the power was P, it reduced to P by 4 because of this short circuiting. So this will attenuate faster. Higher frequency will attenuate faster. So we have to used for low frequency. Low frequency, and in the low frequency we have AM waves. So it is used for low frequency. Higher frequency, high frequency attenuate fast. So what is the frequency range we use for this? Few megahertz. Few megahertz means around 5 megahertz. Okay. So only for this small frequency range we are using this. And when the range of frequency is small, then what about the wavelength? The wavelength will be large. Large wavelength. So we use it for a short range because it attenuates fast. So that is one disadvantage. Have we written it anywhere? Yes, it is. What is the disadvantage of ground wave? It is short range. It is using small frequency. Lot of disturbance is there. It is amplitude modulated. Because of this, it gathers noise. This is a disadvantage. Okay, the range is also very small, few kilohertz to few megahertz. So at one place we cannot have many transmitters. Limited transmitters. We cannot have many transmitters. All disadvantages are there. Is there any advantage? Yes, there is. The advantage is that it has got a large wavelength, and when there is a large wavelength, then this signal can bend round the corner, bend round the corners more efficiently. It spreads very wide. We have gone through interference pattern and diffraction pattern. What does diffraction say? It says the light bends round the corner. That means if there is an obstruction here, okay, bend round the obstructions. Okay, so if this is an obstruction, the wave is going from here, and whether this wave can cross through the obstruction or not, it depends upon the wavelength. Why? It can go, it can spread, it can bend, and we have studied that bending of the light, this first dark, this bending of the light theta is proportionate to lambda. Theta is proportionate to lambda because we know here sine theta is equal to lambda by d. So if d is fixed, then theta is proportionate to lambda. That means more is the lambda, more will be bending. If larger lambda, it will bend so much. Larger lambda, it will bend so much. Now, if the wave is coming from here and here is the obstruction, that it will bend, and after bending, it will go through here and it can reach here. So it depends upon lambda. You see, the wavelength of light is very, very small compared to wavelength of sound, which is very, very large. I won't give the data. So what happens to this? Larger wavelength, larger bending power. Both waves are going from one place to other place, light and sound, and here is a wall. Both waves are going from here. These are light waves and these are sound waves. Here is a wall. I am sending this both. I am visible to the wall and I am speaking something. My friend is here. This person is here. Can he see me? Why he can't see me? Because the light going from me cannot jump the wall. But can he hear me? Answer yes. He can hear me. Why he can hear me? If there is a wall in between, the answer is because this sound waves can jump the obstruction, bend round the obstruction. Why? Because their wavelength is very long. If you are walking with small steps, very small steps, and there is a stone on the way, you are bound to strike it and stop. If you are doing large steps, this, you have an obstruction on the way, you will go around it. So larger wavelength gives you a freedom to cross the obstructions, larger wavelength. Smaller wavelength, you cannot cross even a very small obstruction. This is a very small obstruction, but wavelength is very small. You cannot cross. And if the wavelength is large, you can cross. So this is the benefit of large wavelength of the ground wave. So in a building, if I am transmitting a signal and that signal is to be caught by my associates who are there all over the building. The one is in the basement, one is on the top floor, one is inside somewhere in the bathroom. So I give a call, everybody receives it because we are having a network on which is working on ground wave propagation, which is a low frequency, large wavelength network. And this is the network what the police is using in their handsets. That is why it is more efficient. If we have a larger frequency operating systems, then those systems may not work in the basement because the bending power of that high frequency is less. So this is the advantage of the ground wave. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Please remember these 5 features of the ground wave propagation. And now we know everything. But one thing is sure, the power of ground wave are the power of the waves which are sent by ground wave propagation is very low because they work only up to few megahertz. But our waves, radio waves, are very, very high in frequency. So we cannot send them through ground wave propagation. Number one. Number two, we want to send our waves to a larger distance. That is also not possible in ground waves. So it is very restricted use. It has very restricted use. We want our radio station to cover, to go carry a signal to 500 kilometer. It cannot go by the ground wave propagation. I want to send my radio signal which has got a larger frequency. So larger frequency can go to the large distance, but ground wave propagation is not fit for this. So I have to take help of another type of propagation for the waves which are having larger frequency than this. So that propagation is known as sky wave propagation. So now in the next lecture we will study sky wave propagation, that how all the disadvantages of ground wave are carried over with or removed in sky wave propagation and what are the advantages of that. Thank you.